Hello and welcome to Scruffy Goggles, Scruffy Goggles Reviews, with me, Terry Kay, beer goggles, but looking all kind of Father Christmassy and everything else, getting ready for Christmas, ho ho ho, stop it. We've got a McEwan's. Now, I've had mixed blessings with McEwan's. I had the McEwan's Champion, which was like, you know, but some people like it. I certainly didn't. And I'm pretty sure that McEwan's Champion, at least, has been taken over by Wells and Young's. I don't know if McEwan's have completely. I'm not exactly certain, so someone please chirp in and say, no, Till. No, they actually this and that and whatever. But I'm pretty sure they did. But nowhere on this bottle says anywhere about Wells and Young's. And it says an independent family brewer. So, I don't know. As far as I know, maybe they just took over a beer or something like that. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. Anyway, let's crack it open and see how we go. Plain crown on the top. Plain crown, shaving that if you want to. And there's nothing to see, move along. Let's have a glass. I've got my beer by the river glass ready to go for it. Really enjoyed that festival, Sandbrooks Festival. Beer by the river, really good. Good fun. Another place to go to in London, and hopefully they'll do it next year. Good Lord, what are we talking here? Are we talking E405, Ed? Please don't say this is it. Got. Oh, no. Look, I'm not going to start moaning already. But that's big meringue type Ed. And you want that to at least die a little bit. Oh, hold on, it's going a bit. No, it might be alright. Might be okay. Is that? No, sometimes almost you can see dipples on the top. You can almost dipple the top like a Guinness that made what I call a Bart Simpson head. With a Guinness, you can go bit, make a Bart Simpson head. Now that's dying down quite naturally, so it looks alright. The colour is mahogany in it. Yeah, that's alright. It's good. Let's see how we go. Yeah, getting strange little hints in here. Getting strange little hints I'm not too sure of. But you're getting little currenty notes. But you're getting a lot of kind of cornflakey, grainy sort of notes. Like an overspent grain. You know when it's brewed out and you brew and brew, kind of not brewed out, like the worts, you know, you run the wort through and you kind of, you know, you've got it hot, and you're getting as much as you can out of it. Sometimes if you leave it too long and too hot or too long and whatever, it kind of gets a bit grainy and a bit peanutty and a bit almost corny in it. It's gone almost corny. In fact, it's gone kind of popcorny as well. Don't think they're using maize, you know, but I don't know. I'm not sure about that aroma. You got a nice toffee aroma, you got a nice currant aroma, and then you got something popcorn. So it's like popcorn with the toffee on it. You know that sugary popcorn. Right, well let's give it a try. Yeah. It's alright, but it tastes of bitterness. It tastes something like burnt sugar. It tastes of burnt sugar and it tastes of it's like a like a coffee edge, but it's a very false flavour, like kind of like a steel, like licking, no, like licking iron, like licking licking a coin of some sort, like a 10p coin in your mouth. It's not that copper taste, it's like a irony sort of taste, a tinny sort of taste of a tin can it ain't come out of, if you know what I mean. It's got some nice little malty flavours, but it also tastes of a kind of cane sugar. It tastes of the actual cane sticks that you get, those kind of, you get in kind of some ethnic shops and things, you get these sort of cane sugar sticks. And it tastes a little bit of those. As Jeremy Clarkson said, is it a chair leg? Is that a chair leg? It's all right. I'd have trouble drinking. I'd have trouble drinking more than half of that. I'm gonna give it a go. Though. What is this? I'm sure I've seen this bottle before. Independent Family Brewers. I'm sure I've seen that before. I'm sure I've seen that before somewhere. And not on McEwan's. I'm sure I've seen it before. Is it? I don't know what it is. But, I don't know. I thought I'd seen it before on something like Badgers or something like that. Don't know. Like Halls and Woodhouse or something. It's got promise, that is. It's got promise as being a good beer. And it's almost there, you know. It's almost there as a good beer, but it's kind of... They ain't getting it. They ain't doing it for me. It's, you know, it's all right. It's passable, but there's so many beers out there that are completely smashed to bits out there. Okay. There we go. It's very uninspirational to me. Was it cheap? I think it was in was it in the Tesco specials? I think it might have been in the Tesco specials. And at the Tesco special price, Tesco special price was £4 for £5. 125, that's okay, you know. When it goes back to normal price, I don't know what price it's going to be. There's loads and loads and loads of beers out there that would smash the daylights out of that. Even in supermarkets and that, without going online and everything else. Pardon me. Loads of beers smash the daylights out of that, really will. So, kind of struggling with the last little half of an off, last little bit of the off. It's not bad, but it ain't rich and subtly complex that it says on the top. What else did it say? Our head brewer carefully blends the finest malts, hops, and natural mineral water to... This sounds like BS, this does. To produce this rich, full-bodied beer. Signature is a fruity, chestnut-coloured, classic ale. He's justifiably proud of. Who is he then? Okay. Yeah. Bombs up, chin chin, cheers. Bum 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 bum. Yeah. It's alright. It's not inspirational, and there's hundreds of thousands of beers out there that smash the daylights out of it. Cheers, everyone.